still going. It's going just fine. Awesome. Okay. Connection. Sorry about that. Hope it's all right. I think that's a little better. I found this piece that I'd already started. It was just in the fabric. Not been done properly, something went wrong. So I went over it with embroidery thread. It's a little thick. Made a little bit of it. I found a bunch of these little Guatemalan worry dolls. So I've sewn them onto the shell. So those are going to be on the, these are already made. I'm just sort of, I had a whole bunch of, I did a big cleanup and, so I went through a big cleanup and I did some organizing and, found a bunch of pieces. And so I decided I'm going to, the mirror's kind of weird, but I can't really move it. It's an armoire. But I think this is a better setup in terms of showing you the machine and how it works. From the front, of course, is that I have to bend over it, and so anywhere I put the camera over here, I'm gonna, as you can see, of course, from the decorations on the back, it is gorgeous. And yeah, it's in really nice shape. There we go. Just give this a bit of a once. No, I forgot to get more oil. Sewing machine oil is super important for these machines. So, I'm just gonna get it in the most important place. So, oil the entire machine. You always dribble a little, there's always a little bit left. And it seems to be that rubbing it gently helped keep the metal nice. I just like to keep it nice. It's with two cats, but do your best. House is too small to, have sort of an exclusive sewing area. Worry dolls are. Any little excess bits, because I just find sometimes very gently. Yeah, that little steam. Steam a little bit of this. It's a little bit. little bit of a fold in this. Ironing board isn't long enough. It's too big. There we go. Much better. Let's see. Having some internet problems. I was trying to that down. I got this in. Now, but I can see right in front of me just fine. Or fine enough. I really need a better one of these. It's like a little hook thing. But I find it not very good. Those little, you can get these little around the needle. Good job! Aha! Check all of the edges, check all of the seams before we put the two together, because if you don't, really don't want to find, but you don't want to put it together and then find a hole and then have to go back, take everything apart. That's also really difficult if you are working with a delicate fabric. This fabric, I mean, all fabric is woven. It's woven more loosely, and if you pull it apart, you can start to unravel the fabric, and that can be hard when you're
times. My mom and stepdad went to visit their friends there. They know some women who run. And she bought it directly from them.
Gotta leave a little bit of a hole to turn it in. See the screen at this point, so I will squint at it.
Tremendously impressed by the quality of this internet we switched to. Gotta say. I didn't touch the iron, it's just the fabric was hot. My phone keeps taunting me with being online. Thank you.
scene. What are you doing, Jen? Hmm? What are you doing, buddy? There you are. Hello. So it's going to be right over their heads. Okay. Well, the nice thing about stripes is that it lets you know exactly where you're going to sew. Doesn't really matter which way I do it anyway, so. Hi, Jen. Going on top of the wardrobe. Jin is. There's a basket. It's freaked me out a few times because I couldn't find him anywhere. And he's really hard to see up there. Wasn't until. Okay. Weird. I've somehow ended up with a bit of extra fabric? Ah. The lining and the shell are just very, very, very slightly different sizes. There's some extra fabric here. So, I need to find a way to fix this. Boo. That's really too bad, because that basically messes up this whole bag. Hmm. Apparently there's nothing I can do about that. Except just... Oh well. Wait a second, I'll show you what happened. Difference in size. And everything lined up. Right until I got... It's still cute. It's still fun. I'm gonna have to go find a ribbon for it. Apparently did not bring a ribbon in here. More things here that I want to try and see if they can make them fit together, see if I can make them work. Get to that. Use those up. Let's see, what have I got here that That's probably why it's here. Okay. That. Ooh. And this. Do I have? Let's see. One piece of that left, but I need a bottom for it. I'm just going to sit here and talk to for that. Well, poop. That doesn't help. Cut. Where the heck are the bottoms? What happened to them? Weird. Where did they go? Oh, hello. Thank you. Hello. I just finished this one. Just below the camera, digging in my stash to find stuff to work with. That's a long enough ribbon. Stuff that I've made already. But some of them, that one doesn't look good. I don't like the look of that. Oh, that's a nice one. I made these and I made the buttonholes already. So, black. Pink is really nice. I have this lining, which I think is kind of unusual. Must be an unusual combination. I have to put something on the outside. This has kind of like a vine thing going on here, so I have to find some kind of decoration for this. Outside of this, that will reflect some of this out of the way. Those are, yeah. Well, I mostly wear black. Some ribbon. I will be right back. Big container of ribbon here. Now, ooh, that's nice, but that's got a little brown in it. This is gonna be long enough. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Well, I can show you how to do that. The nice thing is you can scale it up and down really easily. You can, you know, use the same pattern to make a... I do like them standing up. I have made them before, you know, made them flat, or you make them as flat pieces, and they time. unless the fabric is, except for the ones with a thinner fabric sometimes. They don't stand up quite as well. There we go. Okay. This ribbon is a little bit short, but it's fine. This is fine. Still stands. It's a little floppy because there's nothing in it, but it's not too bad. So these are these little worry dolls on it. It's really too bad that it came out all weird. The ribbon, but it's fine. We will just put that here. Really don't want to use anything too hot on this stuff, or you'll just melt it, and then it's awful and it never comes off your heat, just to take out some of the wrinkles and the folds. A tablecloth. Used it for many, many years, but it acquired and I cut it up, and I've been using it the good parts. I really like taking apart that. So these I already cut out. I actually made a template for the dice bags because same size, they line up nicely because you want to make sure that your lining and your shell are the exact same. It was not very straight with my cutting. That's okay. This is why you measure twice and cut once. Like this vintage fabric and stuff like that, because you don't have a lot of it, so you want to be careful. Just trim this little bit of excess off. There we go. Trim this little bit off. So, we need to pick an outside decoration for our black material. Let's see. I'm sorry about this noise. I'm sure it's not pleasant. Oh, there. Maybe a little lighter than what we've got here, but it is pretty. Let's see. You know, when I'm putting decorative ones on the outside, I don't want it too fine, because then it becomes long, and that's very frustrating. I am not to be a little bit more patient. It doesn't necessarily have to be the same green. It just has to look good together. It has to be something. Just gonna go with this green one. It goes together nicely. Making dice bags, or, well, these pouches is, the size is great. I mean, it's obviously it's not full yet. You fit quite a lot of dice in here. But these kind of pouches are also great for all kinds of other stuff, like anything little you want to carry around, change, makeup, all kinds of stuff. So, wipe off fabric, some really easy to wash fabric for the liners. That would be really easy to make makeup bags out of. Pull the ribbon under the iron. Seems to work quite nicely. Make sure we've got some access on the outside. Cause out. Pinking shears. Is cut like that, and it helps with fabric that is woven, stuff that comes apart. It helps it to stay together. We gotta get rid of our red. We don't want to sew this in red. Machine. We all store everything in the same place. Always had the bobbins in that. Let's see, we're gonna need a good color for this. Aha! That looks rather obnoxious. I can just use white. That'll be fine. Totally use white. I have a bobbin already filled. Instead of having to wind them up to the green. Oh, wait. Oh no, it's a super bright green. Probably like, I think it's my thread and colors or something at some point. I just kind of shoved them in the drawer. Through our little process of loading the machine. Yeah, I don't think I have enough of that other green to make a bobbin and this is a completely different. Why is this stuck? There we go. Kind of bobbin on this. Some of which you could buy preloaded. I actually found some companies have started making treadle machines again. They're a little different than this one. Some newly made ones. So. That's going to be nice. I'm going to keep every now and then. I'm just going to order myself a few more, and then I've got my nice... When I first started using it, we only had the handful of bobbins that we had, so you always had to just sort of keep winding, you know, the color that you needed. And this is not a good hook. It does not hook. It's supposed to hook the thread and pull it through, but the little hook at the end is just not long. Thread. There. Okay. Got that. We're gonna. There. Now that we've done that, we want to make sure. What's the good side of this ribbon? This side is nice. Make sure this is nice and lined up. Oh. sure that this is gonna sit nice and straight on here, and that it is going to line up on both sides. You have a seam that doesn't line up. Okay, so let's drive it on. Oops. All right, now for this, we really want to go nice and slow on the very, very edge of the ribbon so that it looks. One of the things I love the most about these machines is just underneath it, I am manipulating to make the to make it go. You know what? We're gonna work on this part. Is that these machines used to plastic was the wood bobbin is significantly heavier. And so sometimes I have found, I sat here and adjusted until I was going crazy. So, let's throw that in there, hopefully that'll help. So this is our liner. Since I have to go and hopefully we're gonna double check all of our settings here. Make a mess. This will make some nice stitches. That backwards on this, so turn around. That doesn't sound right to me. I don't like that sound. So now that we've got this piece, so I took the long piece and I folded it. So I decided that this is going to be the bottom. We're going to take our bottom ring, and I like to start at the seam, just find it easier. You can go around and pin this, but go around and we're good. Come on. Here we go. Line up the edges and stop. Readjust. Line up the edges again. That's what I think about that. Button thread, super thick. Big old one. The problem with saving thread is it's just not usable anymore because it just comes apart. It completely comes apart on you. Okay. Let's see if this one. Now, this shouldn't need the extra weight. That'll be nice. Another trick to this. Oh, I thought I did. Yeah, I find this a little harder to thread because the modern machines go. Get out of the way, you. Okay. Remember to sit up straight, not just slouch all over the machine. Fabric here, that's not good. I'm just gonna throw a few stitches on top of that, make sure it's okay. There we go. And some of you might remember if you had anybody in your family that sewed. They might have been very, very picky, especially when you were a kid and you were doing crafts, about not using sewing. In order to be effective, and if you use them on paper and things like that, then you're going to wear them down. So, they are not permitted to be used for any other tool. I have my painting shears as well, and then I also utility dollar store scissors that I can just use for anything. So I have my spare set of scissors for like other stuff that I need to do. It can be really hard to get a nice straight line. If they're not sharp enough, you will also kind of chew up the fabric as you cut, and that's, you don't want that. Vintage fabric, you only have a small amount of it. So keeping your sewing scissors nice and sharp is a really good idea. I should actually get these sharpened. A little bit of thread coming through. So I'm just gonna go around the bottom again. And I find, especially with a dice bag, you really want this bottom pulling in this direction against the stitching. So sometimes when I go back over it, I'll and I sew it this way. So this time I'm gonna flip it over and just sew around the edge of the circle just to make sure. And I find that this technique also you know, and even if you've pinned it right, it's a good idea to double check. I don't know if you can hear me while I'm sewing. Got snagged. Okay. Let's fix that right there. Okay. There's something down on this machine. Don't want to make a mess. Scratch up the furniture. So even though this is pretty thin, brick, you can see, stands up very nicely, just because of the shape and the way that this comes. I know how to make these now. Now it's just a matter of getting all of my texture and oil, which is a problem. So I need to get some more of that. Not having enough of that isn't a big deal. Treadle machine really needs quite a bit. The instruction manual says that you should oil it every time you use it. Every few times, definitely. It kind of depends on how long you're using it for, too. I mean, if you're going to be sewing all. So. I hope you guys are having a good day. And tomorrow, cheap chocolate day. Not cheap chocolate. Inexpensive chocolate. Inexpensive chocolate is good. Cheap chocolate is not. And as someone who is mildly allergic now, which is really nice, not always having to be on DEFCON 5 around food, but, man, I gotta tell you, it's hard to actually even just, like, get anything that's really chocolate. It's all, you know, chocolatey, chocolate flavor. All I can eat or I will die. It's not fun. I really hope the, oh man, the nut-free bakery must be doing wonders today. Baking, and even though I'm not definitely allergic anymore, I still love going to them because, and I strongly suggest you go there whether or not you have an allergy. First of all, helping them stay in business, good idea. Everybody allergies needs that kind of assistance. nut-free baking is that in order to get that certification and ensure that they are truly completely nut-free, they make absolutely everything from scratch. So you are going to be getting a from scratch. So even if you don't have an allergy, the quality of the nut-free baking is going to be really good. Where there's going to be a lot of people there that you're not sure about, you know, bringing something from a nut-free bakery would just be. Was so thoughtful. They had bought my mom a big cake, you know, great big, one of those great big allergy, and bought me a nut-free cupcake to have on the slide. It was so thoughtful, it was so touching, and it was such my night. I you know, because the majority of the time when I went out, when I did have the deadly allergy, it was just never dessert. There was never a dessert. I never got to have dessert. It was just... I think I need my life right now. I'm gonna have a lot of gaming streams pretty soon, though, so I guess I shouldn't complain. Enjoy my time while I think I like this setup better. I think this allows you to see more of what I'm doing. Stitch Ripper is another thing that you should make very strict rules about, and also have several of. Get a bunch of these. They disappear. So many. I'm like, I can just use this for, like, turning this little thing or whatever. There's some stuff. Okay. This faux leather really, I mean, you can just see the line of stitching where I've gone through, which is really why I don't get it nice and lined up. And go right back over your stitches. Otherwise, you will see that there were stitches there, and they are now gone. And then... crappy foam. Okay. Hey. Wait. There's a tension spring. Helps balance the thread. And if you, because the minute anything gets hooked up in there, it messes up your machine, it messes up your stitching. I thought I'd figured out the trick to this teeny little hook here. Sort of putting the. You know what? There we go. Still easier than sitting there and going, trying to get through the. That's so annoying. Proper this time and not do all of this nonsense with the skip stitching. Staying on track here. Oops. Oh. Oh, it got caught again. Huh. I don't know why it's being so jumpy today. Looks like it was unwound and then rewound by hand. Oh! Sometimes about keeping things. There. Would not be surprised if she wound all of this thread. He makes the best waking up noises. If you wake him up, he makes these like adorable little kind of sounds. It's super cute. Distracted for 2 seconds, and then missed a couple of stitches. Sides, that's nice. Okay, line this up. You have to be careful with this, huh? Because thank you. simple little project to do. Turn the brain off for a little while. Or there's nowhere where it's just very too close to the edge, and it'll eventually, if it's not, just throw a few extra stitches right around the seam where everything's coming together. Not, there's nothing wrong with it. I just want to double up on it just for a little added security at that point, because that's the point at which. We did all our measurements correctly, we didn't make any mistakes during the sewing, didn't leave too much edge, you know, that sort of thing. Kind of suspicious. Because I said so. I'm gonna have to finish this up and then get more sewing machine oil and white thread. Either it's buried somewhere in the drawer or I didn't see it. Bits of thread on this here. Okay. There's my gap. There we go. Put this in low so that I don't melt. my big leather here. You need special needles for it, but other than that, which I think I have a couple of. Yeah, this machine is cool. You can get it under here. You can sew it. It would be kind of nice if this was area. Okay. Now, this part is annoying. It over, none of your stitches are showing, none of your edges are showing. And the fabric will not want to fold. I'm just going to start doing a little ironing on the side. Flatten out the easy side first. Fold started, it's easier to keep it going. Oh, come on. Line up. Really, really important. Oh no! I melted it a little bit. It's fine, it's fine. It's totally fine. No. Except you just said you're not going to burn it, but yeah. Okay, this is being fine now. But we should make them. I would very much like a better iron at some point. I believe there are some that will shut themselves off after a certain amount of time. Forgotten to turn off the iron. And that is never a good thing in a house with pets and or children. And or... Fold over already. Disobey me. Where else? There. So got that advantage now. I kind of feel like I shouldn't have used white on the outside. Stitch or drawstring stitch. Okay, there's the buttonhole. Make sure I get under that. That's a weird, weird thread. A friend of mine who is a crafter says, if you're not swearing, then you're doing something wrong. She works with itty bitty tiny everywhere, so. It would. Be a huge mess if I ever tried to work with those, I'm sure. Or the fabric not cooperating. Okay. I'm trying to get this nice and lined up so that we can have a nice, even stitch. Didn't break. I actually made it all the way around. Oh. Sneaking suspicion something did not go right here. Well, this is just gonna be the stream of everything going wrong, isn't it? Yep. I need, like, 2 more inches of sewing. Oh, I got this white. Something. This much space. Like 4 fingers worth of space. And I have to load up the whole bobbin for this. I don't think I've praised Noya enough today. Over all small, easily misplaced objects. And things sticking in drawers. So I praise her often. There we go. Alright, might as well just load all of that on since it's gonna come off anyway. I don't know if I was my grandma or somebody else, but I was just loading all the white thread they could find on this thing. If for those of you who use these machines, or you're trying to learn how to use these machines, these bottles, I will give proper instruction on how that's done. It's a little bit of a trick to it, and I know how to do it. Definitely need a replacement for this little guy. Your foot is nice and tight. Where's that bottom thread? Come on out. Lining it up and making it look tidy. Because, of course, I chose to do white thread on a black fabric. Okay. So, start right there. Just go back a couple of stitches off where we ended. Sure it stays firm. And I usually try and it seems to, you know, kind of cover up any minor errors or that little bit of extra stitch. You know, I swear, like, it's, some days, it's just like Murphy's Law, you know? If you're working, and you stitching, and the day where you're doing white thread on black, where all of your mistakes are super obvious. Oh, come on! What's this nonsense? What are you doing? What? What? Why are you coming apart? Back over the whole bloody thing. If it's going to be like that. And I went to all the trouble of redoing my bottom, so. Jumped off the tension wheel. That is bad. That is definitely an effect of there not being an there we go. Much better. Okay. This one might do. Definitely got a much smaller hole on this one, but this should be just barely long enough, I think. I'm going to need a smaller pin. I took a very large pin. So for this, it's particularly small. I'm gonna go see if I can find myself some Valentine's chocolate. I haven't had any all day. And really, oh, I'm so close. Whoops. Yep. It's definitely the everything goes wrong time. I can't even catch the edge of the ribbon. See if we can catch the end of the ribbon without poking holes in the bag. Where's the end of the ribbon? Nope, I'm not gonna be able to catch it. I'm just gonna have to feed it all the way through again. Take this ribbon out. Start over, but once sometimes you gotta go a little outside the box, do something different. I like to try and make a bunch of different ones in case, you know, some so everybody can have a kind that they something that they like. So there we go, there's our bags for today. Here's our little worry doll bag. Thank you very much for joining me. I appreciate the people that came and hung out during the stream and said hello. Quick look, oops. Hey, stop that. Tablet's being weird. Okay. The machine there. You can see all the full the detail on it. Yeah. I am so pro with this. Okay, here we go. You can kind of see it now. Quite hard to see the pedal. It's I've got a dark floor and it's steel. Shot of a cat. Ooh. Hide up here.
You up there, Jen?
Oh, I can't see you. You're hiding.